every location after that, we want it to be a new kind of food-based set.
The idea of letting our production design sort of go crazy with these different worlds.
There's like a ham canyon where there's like giant hams with pools of gravy and mashed potato.
Meat town.
Yeah, meat, going to meat town.
And of course there's the pickle village, which is where would pickles want to live but a cheese town.
Yes, yeah.
So it's like a little kind of cheese harbor on the edge of the island.
We love the idea of like getting trapped in this pancake syrup breakfast bog.
Syrup is my favorite.
It's really just kind of like a barren wasteland of syrup and like these pancake towers. And it represents a kind of a hardening of Flint's bad choice.
Our opinion doesn't matter?
Of course it does.
Really?
Yes, but it's not right now.
Uh-oh. Wrong answer.
Toast.
Sam tries to storm away, but she can't because it's syrup.
Sam.
And she has to walk through it. Honestly, it was our effects lead, Theo, who had this whole experiment where he bought all this syrup and he kind of filled it up in these...
It was like, I think, giant trays.
Yeah, they filmed themselves walking through it.
Nice. Nice. Oh, yeah.
And the funny thing was at the end, they put it all in the garbage bags and threw it out in the back of the lot here.
Right, but it started to leak through the dumpster and it kind of looked like motor oil.
And nobody knew what it was, so the hazmat team was called in and it was like this big thing where they were evacuating part of the building and it was just like a big to-do and it was just syrup. And then, of course, there's Big Rock Candy Mountain, where Flint really connects with his creativity again.
Justin would always say, is like, sugar is one of the building blocks of life.
Sugar is one of the building blocks of life, and that is the heart of the island, and that's where the Flintismifer is.
The Flintismifer was like a ball of color in the first film, so it allowed us to kind of take that color, and it would go through these rock candies like a prism, so the whole place lit up.
In terms of making the film, the most fun is really just working with the other artists and the actors that we get to work with, like collaborating with other people.
The most important thing to the directors and I was that we created something that nobody had ever seen before.
And it was 2.5 years of a lot of people throwing drawings against the wall to suddenly just see that click happen, and just see it fall into the film. And the movie's really a journey about finding what home is.
Yeah, and what family and friends mean.
I'm proud of you, son.
And then the idea that food is people, too. Every shot, the food is supposed to look tasty. So that collision was a really appealing thing that kind of created really pretty, fun characters.